SpaceX is currently the only U.S. company capable of launching astronauts safely to and from the ISS. SpaceX and competitor Boeing are part of NASA's Commercial Crew Program that aims to conduct frequent, rotational spaceflights to the orbiting outpost from American soil. 8 years ago, the business of U.S. space changed exactly in 2014. NASA tapped SpaceX and Boeing to build two new human-rated spacecraft, the Crew Dragon and the Starliner, respectively. Each company would prove its ship capable of safe flight and perform as many as 6 crewed missions to the International Space Station. From that moment onward, Boeing could not forward its Starliner being compared to what SpaceX is achieving with the Crew Dragon capsule. Boeing has not yet been able to complete its test flights, and hasn't even performed even one crewed mission. But SpaceX, well, that contract has proved a resounding success. Unsurprisingly, NASA has recently even asked SpaceX to help keep the ISS stuff full of astronauts in future years. The Boeing Starliner, that's definitely a shame if it survives compared to the SpaceX Dragon, but for the most convincing, let's take an exact look. In what ways does the Dragon outperform Starliner Crew Dragon, and Starliner 2 space capsules both alike in dignity? But with plenty of differences between them, starting with the manufacturer, these two spacecraft are both reusable space capsule, designs capable of seating up to 7 crew and ferrying cargo to low Earth orbit and the International Space Station. However, right out of the gate, Boeing got the better treatment from NASA, $4.3 billion, to finish developing the Starliner and carry out 6 crewed missions. While SpaceX received only $2.5 billion for basically the same job, and not only that. Boeing got an additional $300 million to cover expenses for overshooting its own project timeline. Despite this, the biggest difference between the two capsules is that so far, only Dragon has successfully flown humans and cargo to the ISS. SpaceX made its first crewed flight in 2020, the company has since run several operational crewed flights to the ISS. In contrast to Boeing Starliner, the Boeing Starliner ran into numerous snags during its uncrewed test flight to the orbiting lab in 2019, and hasn't had the chance yet to return to space for a second try. Numerous issues including launch windows, the pandemic technical concerns. It all meant Starliner would likely not launch again until at least May 2022, crewed flights they may not follow until 2023 or after. This means for now that Crew Dragon is the only option for NASA astronauts or space tourists to leave for orbital space from American soil. Notably, relations between NASA and Russia have been rocky recently after Russia's invasion of the Ukraine on February 24, which prompted numerous international sanctions. NASA doubtless is breathing a sigh of relief that an American crewed orbital capability is up and running well. In this case, SpaceX may also be able to replicate some Russian services to the ISS. Such as rebooting the orbiting complex periodically, to avoid drag from the Earth's atmosphere, pulling the station back to the planet, and these emergency situations. What can Boeing do when it hasn't even once left the ground? Next, even Dragon technology also gives a big humiliation with Starliner. Frankly, Boeing is making technology that look the same as it did many decades ago. The Crew Dragon 2 has a better heat shield, it could enable it to be used for faster re-entry back to Earth, thus enabling it to function beyond LEO, that the ISS is in. Importantly, if Boeing succeeds fully, which we really hope they do, they'll only be able to produce 2 launches per year. It's a one-use throwaway rocket system built from legacy parts of the space shuttle. SpaceX redesigned their rockets and Crew Dragon capsule from the ground up by reverse engineering old engines and systems, and so many other things, and radically improving each area with 21st century interfaces, materials, and know-how. Now let's talk about the size and capacity aspect. The Starliner capsule is a silver, somewhat squat, broad-based cone shape coming in at just over 17 feet tall, and just under 15 feet in diameter. The completely autonomous Starliner is required to carry 4 NASA crew members, and scientific research when it eventually travels to the ISS. Meanwhile, Dragon is a more elongated candy white cone-shaped capsule that's 26.5 feet tall. The diameter just over 13 feet with 11 cubic meters of internal volume. It makes parachute-aided splashdowns in the ocean when its working orbit is done. It's fully autonomous, it can be monitored and controlled by onboard and astronauts, and SpaceX Mission Control out of Hawthorne, California. It has two main elements, the capsule which carries crew and cargo and the trunk and three windows. Its astronauts' specific amenities include four big windows. Advanced avionics, computer systems, touchscreen displays including controls for interior temperature, which can be set from 18 to 27 degrees Celsius, and of course seating Crew Dragon is outfitted with an emergency escape system, which consists of 8 Super Draco engines built into the capsule walls. If something goes wrong at any point during Crew Dragon flight, these engines can fire up and carry the spacecraft and passengers to safety. Starliner's emergency escape system consists of 4 launch abort agents built into the capsule service module. Boeing performed a hot fire test of these engines, which were provided by an aerospace company Aerojet Rocketdyne, but detected a propellant leak shortly after. One part that cannot be ignored is the space suit. The sleek black and white SpaceX space suits also got a 5-star rating from NASA astronauts Behnken and Hurley. I bet you we've done on and off those suits a couple hundred times, Hurley said during an interview from onboard the space station June 1st. They were actually much easier to get in and out of in zero-G. Starliner's blue space suit also looks strikingly different. The suits are covered in Boeing trademark blue. The overall look, however, is arguably a far cry from the SpaceX divisive tuxedo, like take with far less favorable shape and boots courtesy of sports outfitter Reebok. That already looks a little dated. Last but not least, SpaceX's commercial crew flight represents savings of $100 million over Boeing. And don't be startled by this, since the Starliner hasn't flown yet, but it's necessary to consider both ticket prices and inflation will add up. SpaceX per ticket cost appears to offer significant savings, relative to the price of flying astronauts on Boeing Starliner. That's assuming, of course, Starliner is eventually certified safe to carry astronauts. The latest per seat ticket price offered by SpaceX is actually $75 million, according to a 2019 report by NASA's Office of Inspector General. Boeing flights were expected to cost about $90 million a ticket, which was already more than Roscosmos was charging, adjusted for inflation. Boeing price works out to $100 million per ticket in today's dollars. Also more than the implied price of a Roscosmos ticket. So compared to what Boeing will charge, SpaceX astronaut tickets represent taxpayer savings, closer to $100 million per space flight. After all, the progress shown by SpaceX makes Boeing look like a snail in a rabbit race. Boeing will never be able to catch up to SpaceX. Boeing likely already has performed a lot of tasks, but perhaps they should be more ambitious, or should have tried to outdo NASA's requirements. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.